Giving our number, cell phone number to the fans or a family member, that's not really an appropriate scenario.
Hello?
Yeah.
Evan? Yeah, it's Shanika. Hey, did you take the dog out? I told you that before I left. Okay, remember, you gotta get the car later? The car? Remember, we have to get there's some oil problem? And you need to pick up the kids. No, it's your turn. It's your turn, and I told you we've had this conversation. Okay? So make sure you pick up the kids at 4. My shift ends pretty soon, and then you need to come pick me up. You need to pick me up because I've got to go on to another shift. You remember we talked about that too? Okay. All right, great. All right, well, I got to go. Thanks. Hi.
Hi.
How's everybody doing this morning?
So this is Tim.
So, what a great crew. So, imagine your mom is the client, or you are the client. I'm your caregiver. And I just got on my cell phone to have a conversation with my husband. How would you feel about that?
Not so good.
He's suspected.
Yeah.
No, that's great. But so not so good. What specifically bothers you about that scenario?
Because I feel like the caregiver didn't pay attention to me, and she didn't respect me as her client or something like that.
Right. That's, you know, in our culture, one of the things is I hope that when you're listening to what we're all about and what you're all about is every client's like family. You know, Gina and I care for our own parents, and we hope, and a lot of what makes our caregivers great is they're walking the threshold, that's their family. And being on the cell phone is just so isn't it disrespectful?
Yes.
You know, how do you feel about that? Is that Leduce? What a cool name. How do you feel about that scenario?
It makes like you're focusing on your personal things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's great. You're focusing on your personal life, which, you know, Wadi's analogy is like baggage. You check it out the door, because I know each and every one of us has a lot going on in our lives, and some of it could be, you know, I have my husband and, you know, we're, you know, whatever, we have kids and we're trying to do that. But when you walk through that threshold, it's 100% your client, your family, you know, you're bringing joy into the fight. With cell phones, how do you feel about cell phones?
As far as what, like, at work?
Like the cell phone in general, do you like cell phones? Do you think it's like really cool?
Yeah.
What do you like about it best? Is that Tanessa?
Convenience.
Convenience. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Convenience. You can get somebody wherever they are. What are some of the downsides, Suzette? What's some of the downsides you see with the cell phone?
It can distract you from things you need to be doing that are more important.
Yeah, beautiful. Beautifully said. Distract you from doing things that are more important. You know, we understand. We, as a team, we met to talk about the cell phone because we're blessed for the most part. Our caregivers respect our policy and so forth, but some do not. And be honest with you, you know, I was sitting in church the other day. I had it in my pocket, and I feel that vibration. It's like this is church. I can see God going, okay, really? You know? It's, you know, I know some shifts are long, like 12 hours, but, by the way, you're the first class we did this, but I talked to Micah, and we thought we'd just have some fun to get across some key points about the cell phone, because we're adamant about it, because you hit all the great points. You're distracted, but moreover, it's disrespectful. Right. Didn't you feel like I came into your space and I was invading your space a little bit? Yeah. You know, when I'm on the plane out my other business life, one thing that just really bothered me, these guys, dudes talking business. I'm like, really? You know, I'm standing around and it's like you don't exist, right? So it's in our policy, and, you know, Micah was going through it. We thought about banning, so, you know, check it at the door, but you know what? There's goodness. emergencies, right? And sometimes the client's phones aren't, you know, they may have a mobile and not reliable. So, you know, Micah will go through the policy, but we're okay with a cell phone. When you come in, the professional part is to check in. I know they want to chat and they go, oh my God, LaDuce, I haven't seen you in so long. Remember, I need to check in. You know, that way we're tracking the visit here, and you know, they get billed that way, and they'll look at it as professional, and most of them will do that. Once I do, we're gonna chat. And then at the end, when you check out. Now during, it should be on vibrate in your pocket, but we may call you, or you may call us, and the we may call you is family emergency. We can't get you, we're driving there. We've done that. We will come if there's something very urgent family-wise that you need to know about or need to take care of immediately. We'll start working on your relief. You know, so you can, family is number one. On the other side, you get these butterflies, and one thing we taught here is, what do you do if you have any type of feeling that something's not quite right? What do we encourage you to do?
Call
the office. Absolutely. So, you know, Mrs. Smith, you've noticed something very concerning, a bruise, or, you know, she's not well. You know, the technique would say, Mrs. Smith, just give me a minute. I'm going to call the office. I have a concern. And it's okay, and you got to ensure safety, right? But to go to another room, or, you know, out of earshot, out of respect, so you can actually have a conversation with us that you don't want to express your concerns right in front of the client. So that's why we have so much respect for what you do. You're in that house. You know, it's like you're the CEO of the house. You're the show, and there's some big responsibilities. So our goal, and you have total support here. We're your wingman, but we want to minimize the usage only to certain times. So thank you for this little, you know, educational thing. But it's really important to us, and from the heart, we're just trying to make sure we're focused on our client, and they feel loved, they feel respected. And by the way, what we're gonna do is we're gonna communicate to all our families to say, here's our policy. So they're like, well, you know, LaDuce was on the phone. It's like, that's right, she was concerned about your well-being, and that's an awesome call. So it puts us, and sometimes we say, let us be the bad guy. You can say, well, I'm following policy, the office, if you have any questions, call the office. We're completely cool with that. That's what we're about. So, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.